I'll do what I can. 16-9 in favor of Kazakhstan. Croatia had a good start and had a good ending, but it wasn't just enough for Kazakhstan on this map. It seemed like Kazakhstan was just a better team.
Yep, I mean, Croatia was up there the first 6-7 rounds, but in the end, I think individual plays from Kazakhstan made a point there, and they brought that half to 10-5, winning that one. See, I mean, pretty good half on your city side, but Croatia kind of played slow, I would say. I think if they played...
You think the tempo was the problem?
Yeah, but I think that if they played a bit faster, they could have got maybe two or three more rounds on the T side.
So, would you agree?
I would actually disagree. I think the reason they were leading 4-3 and the reason they were starting to lose rounds is because they looked that they kind of rushed their strats,
okay.
I mean their executes. They were pretty good at getting map control. I think they forced Mo. I think they were able to shut him down pretty much. Revy even winning a couple of battles against Mo. And not only that, whenever he went for A, went for some kind of aggressive push that you can do on in the balloons area, he got chased away. And they were able to push him back to the site. So they were good at that. But once they get the control of map, that map control, get the toilets area, the A long, it seems that they, you know, getting all that control, it kind of rushes them to move forward, to go for that A site. And I think I commented that on that A take they have with the smokes and Molotovs, they all land perfectly, but there's no flashes. And there was one round where Zlex, I think, picks up a double kill. He's in that spot that you always check when you get into the A site, and one flash getting in from A long or from short, any flash, basically, gets him in that spot. And one flash, and he's not gonna make a double kill there. You're gonna take him out. You know, just some mistakes here and there. But
I'll
agree with you. I think the Kazakhstan was just a better team. Asian especially. I mean, they were able to shut out Mo, even though I thought that's going to be a tougher task for them. But Revy surprised me.
In the end, he had couple of good frags.
Yeah.
But all in all,
I think Asian was really a force to be reckoned with.
Their T side looks solid with five rounds. That's okay-ish, I would say. But in the other half, they just couldn't connect anything up until the very end.
They actually won first pistol round, so
yeah,
they had a chance of coming back. Definitely, if you win two more, you're 10-8.
Yeah.
And you can come back from that. But I think they lost.
The second round, after winning the pistol round, that was great. That was what they needed to get back. But then that set up for the second round. You know they're going to force buy because they didn't get a bomb plant. And their lead is not that huge to go for a double save. So you know they're going to buy tech nines. And you go and play aggressive on A with only two guys. I mean, you're going to get overrun 9 out of 10 times.
Yep.
Yeah, why I said they kind of play slow, and I have a replay of only one round on their T side.
Let's check it out.
Actually, and if we can pause here just for a second. As you can see, like they got control of the toilets area long and stuff like that, but look at Fitch. He's already on T spawn, so they kind of stood in their place, like trying to get that guy jumping behind that SWAT truck or whatever you call it in the bank, and again, yeah, he gets a kill on Adrian. That's a really good start for them. But the problem is, Kazakhstan had all the information that they're definitely going A. They could maybe just throw smokes and go from a connector area, maybe go to B, because the guy is rotating from T spawn and he's not really covering that connector area, and Mo is already rotating, so they definitely could maybe change the pace and go for a B and get around there. But even this one, like they kind of wanted a peak, then they wanted to come back, but they already got a peak, so they wanted to go into A site. As we see here, they're entering the site with C4. They have...
And this is the spot I was actually talking about.
Yeah.
One flash, and he's down. And he gets a double kill.
Yeah, that's a flash from A long. Really cool pop flash from A long. So, and they have, like... No,
three
they have
two.
Yeah, but they want to face Mo.
He was allowed to repeat here
again and again. Like Nyx could have just planted the bomb and go in post plant position, but they wanted to to go and frag. Ravi gets a really nice kill on Mo here, but he doesn't expect Fitch to come from his back, and Fitch kills him in the end. But I think, first of all, yeah, okay, they decided to go for A, but second of all, why would you pick against the AWP and you know it's Mo? Like, he's a great operator. You had a chance to plant the bomb and go on possible. If they planted the bomb and then went on A long, they could have killed that guy that rotated from T-spawn. And you basically have 3-on-1, he's with AWP, you don't give him a chance to retake that site, and you basically won the round. But
is that because, you know, they're a little bit intimidated by the names, you know, Mo, Adrian, stuff like that, or is it just inexperience?
I don't think so. I mean, yeah, in that round, you should definitely shouldn't chase for Mo like that, but honestly, if he gets one kill from the same position, he's, I mean, 9 out of 10 times, if he does that on a top level, he's going to get killed. I mean, even 10 out of 10 times.
Yeah.
You can't repeat with an AWP from the same spot, like in two consecutive seconds over and over again, and he did it for 3 times, I think, so he's going to get his head blown off if he does that against better teams. I don't know why they went for him. Just holding that line, if he's going to re-pick, you're going to kill him with an AK. I'm 100% sure. At least nine out of ten times. That was a mistake. He was allowed to do that. I would agree. I mean, that was a mistake that they tried and went to get him.
Yep.
Well, no need for that.
The second map is Dust 2, picked by Kazakhstan. Then again, you know, Kazakhstan sealing the first map from Croatia. Do you think they can bring it back to 1-1 and take this series into overtime, into decider?
I said it before the match started, they need this overpass because I don't think they can take Dust 2. Even, as I said, I think they can maybe do it. I don't see Dust 2 going their way anyway.
Yep.
I thought that's going to be overpass and what, cash?
Yep.
I mean, Dust 2, this is the map where Mo can finally shine. He was kind of shut down on that overpass. Yeah, he got a few kills here and there, but I think he didn't have a great game overall. I mean, it's not all about Adrian and Mo. Hobbit also had a good game. Fitch was just abusing that spot in barrels. I don't know why they didn't kill him sooner. You can boost to kill that guy. He was abusing that spot over and over again.
Yeah.
And I mean, going into Dust 2, I just don't see it for Croatia.
I definitely agree with him. I wanted them to take the tower pass because they kind of played it good in those two matches they played before. So I, even though I said like my mind is with Kazakhstan and my heart will go with Croatia, I don't think they can take Dust 2. Not because they really played poor, let's say like that, against Belarus and Dust 2.
Okay, a quick reminder before we get into the predictions for our viewers about the giveaway we're having. So if you want to participate, you have to take a picture of yourself supporting your nation. So basically you need to have a flag or something that says who are you cheering for, and post it on Facebook or Twitter with a hashtag TWC2016. For more info about this giveaway, you can read it right below, or I can tell you can go to bit.ly/TWC2K16. Yeah, we have a lot of prizes. I don't have time to tell you what are they now, but you can find it on the link. Go with the predictions. Let's see if you're going to be right this time.
Yeah, I think Kazakhstan got this. I'm going to go with something like 16-7 for Kazakhstan. I don't think Croatia can take this one. Mario had a poor game. He said if he's going to play bad the first map, someone is going to replace him. I don't see that improvement for Croatia.
16-9, Kazakhstan. Sorry,
you forgot who's playing. Yeah. Kazakhstan versus Croatia, second map, Dust 2, Harry and Mega Man. Let's go live.
They've gone back on what they said, Harry.
Yeah, well, what can I say? We made a pretty good case for it to go that way. But now we're going to be going straight into
Croatia's
this hobbit.
Croatia's making a pretty good case here in the pistol round, opening up on 2-3. Yet they have a casualty on their side. Still pushing up. Nyx! Alright! Well, okay. He just goes ham sandwiches into the round and finds 4. Done deal. Croatia 1-0.
Yeah, no, very, very fast start there for Croatia and a good start at that as well, as they do secure the first round. And now we'll be on the respective anti-eco. They do get a few SMGs here, and then they have the rifles as well. They don't want to leave anything to chance here. They want to try and hold on to this lead. And that is particularly obvious in their choice of weapons here. So anyway, we're going to be seeing the Kazakhstan side opting to go through a lower tunnels kind of play here, predicting some sort of split B or perhaps something along those lines as bomb does get left up in towards upper tunnel. Smoke goes in and well, the push is going to be underway as Stoll does find one. Murray actually gets one as well. Revy comes in with one of his own, so there's lots of kills being exchanged back and forth. Fitch managing to pick up one on the Stoll. It's going to get traded out by Revy, and it's all going to fall into a Dren here. He does still have that bomb. And does still have a Tech 9 and armor, so he's still extremely dangerous. But it just comes down to who's going to win this Angel in mid. Mariachi and Adren exchanging bullets, and well, Mariachi does come out on top, so that means it's going to go 2-0. Croatia only losing one player there, which is exactly what they needed to keep on building a healthy economy as we move into the third round now.
Man, this is the big one right here. This is going to be about as easy as it gets for Croatia if they screw this up. I don't know what to tell you. They're going full aggression towards mid. I like the call. They're going to get in their faces early and often. There you go. The PP Bazong going to work. There it is. 3-4. No. Nick's going to steal away the last one. The assist kings. They both get assists on all the kills. Nick's gets 3 assists and 2 for stolen that situation. But that PP Bazong going to go to work. Finds himself 3 kills with it. That's a lot of money. $1,800 to be exact. And Croatia is going to be sitting pretty as far as their buy down is concerned into this one. In Kazakhstan, they're going to have decent utility into this round. Got the 5 AKs. They're going to have an op in the hands of Mo. It could be a little problematic at the beginning of this round. But for now, it's going to be a little bit of a slow play. A little aggression here on Catwalk from Revy. He's going to flub the nade first, but then drops it out later. And it's going to find about 23 points of damage onto Adren. So, decent little early find here for Croatia.
Yeah, man, Revy, of course, having that AWP does mean that Croatia are in a fairly good place to hold on to this A site. We have got him playing long right now, but I imagine he's going to be falling back, watching the short angle. And like you say, there's no AWP on Mo to counteract that. So potential here for Revy to make something happen with that. You've got 3 players from the Kazakhstan side pushed up on a short now with Zyx heading over towards long, making his way downtown slowly but surely, waiting for that smoke to fade. And it is looking like A is going to be the site in question here. I think a lot of it's going to depend on how much of an impact Revy can have with that AWP. Of course, if he does manage to take down one, then I imagine the push might just get cancelled out if no one's there to trade for him. So, you know, a lot of potential here, but it does all come down to Revy. Of course, if Revy gets taken down and the A site is gone, basically, the push is going to be underway. And while there's lots of aggression, Adren fully committed, jumps down through the smoke into CT. Revy does get one, but now all attention looks towards Long to take him down. Zlex slowly pushing him through Long. Adren does get taken down, though, again by Revy. So now he's on 2. And it's going to hop in a pit, just trying to play the safe. Bomb gets planted over towards short. Fitch rotates in order to watch the post-plant position. And Hobbit is going to opt to stay close onto the site. Nyx finds one on his legs, and now it's going to fall on a Fitch and Hobbit to hold onto this 2v4. Hobbit gets one onto Revy. It's going to peek out. Nyx gets one over towards short, and while Mariachi gets a return frag on a Hobbit, that means the defuse is going to come in favor of Croatia. And they are going to take it 4-0 now, and they managed to get the AWP as well to take into the next round.
Repeat after me, Harry.
Yep.
Mariucci.
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 Mariucci, I'm sorry.
There you
I
go.
Just, I've already, I've already
This isn't Spanish
say it,
band with guitar.
Yeah, I know,
and
but I wish it was. How entertaining would that be? Are you not entertained? Oh man, I could jive to this.
I've had enough. All right, so the smoke's come out to abate any pushes coming around from tunnels. That's going to fall back on the terrorist side. Next, though, going to take an aim duel. I don't think they were ready for Kazakhstan to have a buy into this round. So it's going to be Mo on the scout, but it's 4 AKs to bolster that. And the early pick. I like this spot, though. I learned about that spot that Revy was just in from Dazed on his stream, where you can actually get boosted up on top of Blue Bin, jump over, and get up on top of what looks to be like some drywall or some concrete barriers over there on that corner, and you can actually spot down over top of the smoke at Long A and get the pick onto the player coming in from the T-side double doors. So that's a nice little find there. A little food for knowledge for you guys.
Yep, and while it's going to go into a 4-on-4, Hobbit out long with the rest of the team. They're going to be here. They managed to pick up one on a Revy. So Revy going down is going to open up that long area as it does give them long control. Furious gets trapped as well over towards the back of sight thanks to the push coming in from Adren, but Stoll coming in through CT. He's gonna go do some good damage onto Adren, but it's not gonna be enough. Does get taken down to 74 HP. Isn't able to pick up a frag for his troubles just yet. And while that bomb does get across, is Adren with his little, you know, catching mitt thing that they use in American sports. I'm just gonna stop.
What the hell are you talking about?
I don't know. In America, you have like those gloves for, is it baseball?
Yes.
Where you, what are they called?
Well, it would be a catcher's mitt is what they're usually called, but they're baseball gloves.
Oh, yeah, that's the one. Dude, honestly, I don't know. You tell me one thing from football.
Tell you one thing from football, what? That you have typically two strikers and four defenders with a sweeper or a stopper or a goaltender, and you've got a couple of midfielders, sometimes four, sometimes three. It depends on the setup that you guys are running on your offensive abilities.
Well, then anyway, Adren's going to come in and start things off with a kill out to Revy. And that means that Kazakhstan are going to be able to secure that one man advantage nice and early on. And, now they're going to be trying to capitalize on that. Thing about its technical issues, I can no longer hear Mega Man, so I guess it's just gonna be this for a while. Stoll's got the AWP up on short. It's gonna get flashed out as to drop down into CT, and now the A site is gonna be completely contested and up for grabs, but bomb is making its way up towards B.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Advantage to the Kazakhstani side as that opening pick goes their way. Fitch is going to be able to answer on the one, dropping off a cat. Stoll's not going to be able to find that. And Dren's going to be able to find one and then get straight at Mariucci outside a window. He's just going to force his way in and he's going to get taken down immediately. So a 4-2 scoreline, Kazakhstan with back-to-back rounds. And we're going to see a lackluster economy now for the Croatian side. Not really going to invest a lot into this round. I can't really say that I blame them on that one, as they are going to have a couple of P250s and a Desert Eagle in hand, but what can they possibly do here? AWP has been swapped over for Mo. He's going to miss the shot, but they are still playing close on the left side of mid. You can see the nades go raining in. Stoll, and you're dead. So the raining on the parade of nades coming down through middle is going to find a lot of damage there, but the follow-up with the AK is going to clean him up, and Mo from T-Spawn, another player in tow, but it's going to be Mo. I'm able to find two of those. See, my rhymes are way better than yours.
Yeah, well, sometimes. And now I'm talking of, there you go. Revy dies, and my segment comes to a close. That's going to be 4-3 now as we go into the 8th round. And, well, let's not forget, this is Kazakhstan's map pick. And currently, I mean, I feel like in comparison to what we've seen them do on Overpass, this does feel a little bit underwhelming.
A little bit, yeah.
I mean, in all fairness, it was only the pissed around and the follow-up that they have lost, but I was still expecting maybe a bit of a better scoreline posted from them. But, you know, it's early days. We're only in the 8th round. The aggressive push from mid is just going to get completely cancelled out by the Kazakhstan here in the firing squad fashion as, well, Croatia walk into that like lambs to the slaughter, and then Mo down mid gets one of his own. It's going to go 4-4, and Kazakhstan, they're just showing me that I'm completely wrong, taking four rounds in a row right now to equalize things out. And, it's going to be the first buy round in a while for the Croatian side. They do get the AWP up on Revy as well as rifles across the board. Lots of utility, lots of kits. That's exactly what we like to see. And, Mo's going to be AWPing that mid-angle. Revy isn't going to be one to challenge, as he doesn't want to have his head taken clean off. That's hilarious to me. Fitch does get taken down for the Kazakhstan side. Croatia currently sporting a one-man advantage.
See if any more heads can clean off into this round, as it is going to be a 5-on-4 situation for the Croatian side. Pushing on forward, they're going to take over mid control right now. Three players up on catwalk, fourth one in tow. It's going to be a Dren, rear of this conga line. Mo is just going to be trying to get that dedicated pick in towards that A-bomb site. You can see Adren lining up a smoke. Going to drop that one out for the cross. Potentially drop a smoke down in towards CT spawn. Go for the flash play as well. You can see here comes the flash over the top. Here comes the peeks out from the terrorist side. Revy, the lone defender on this bomb site. And Hobbit's going to just deny that completely. He finds the headshot and there's nobody else home. It's going to be a retake 4-on-4. For the Croatians, see if they can do anything from these positions, but it's going to be extremely difficult for them moving forward. And the off from Mo is up by Goose. He's going to be raining bullets down on long A, trying to find this player that's in pit. But the three other remaining CTs are coming around from CT spawn. Mo trying to split the difference between those barrels, not going to be able to find it. But this player on the site, there you go. Selex is going to jump up. Not going to be able to get the pick, and there is a kit in the hands of Nyx. We will win another round. Croatia going to pick that one off.
Yeah, no, Croatia, they do secure their fifth round, and as such, to come out with a one-round advantage over Kazakhstan, things were looking like they were going to get a little bit close, you know, a little bit with Croatia's back against the wall there, but they do manage to hold on to that round in the 4-on-4 retake, and as a result, I'm going to see them with a, you know, an okay buy going into this round. Maybe not as much utility as they would like on a Furious, but other than that, plenty of utility across the board, and I love this boost that they're doing up on a short right now. That's going to give them complete control of mid in the early stages of this game. Potential to spot out Mo as well as he heads down Suicide, and, well, look at this. Stoll does get one on a Fitch. Mo's going to be there to try and trade for him. He's going to be pushing down mid. Now, there's no one there to trade for Stoll. There's going to be the only downside as he does get dropped, so it's going to equalize into a 4-on-4. And, well, over towards Long, Adren slowly edging out with that AVP in hand. He does have a really nice skin for it as well, as I'm of much love. And, well, he's been playing that pit angle, does pick up one on a Revy. That's going to open up that A site almost completely. It's all going to fall onto Furious, just hiding by these stairs. Like, who lives under a staircase? Someone in something. Maybe Harry Potter. Yeah, that's Jeez. The one. I thought it was. I'm really careful with my use of Harry Potter because it's just like instant bullying considering my name's just Harry. But yeah, no.
You're the one that made your alias that.
Hey. It was clever at the time. Now it's a regret every day of my life.
When did you come up with that alias? Be honest. How old were you?
Nah, man, this was recent.
Oh my god.
Yeah, dude.
That makes it worse.
Yeah, I know. But anyway. Furious over towards Short, gonna be doing all he can. Mao's in top mid, and now Mo's in top mid. It's gonna get taken down by Nyx, and as a result, it's gonna go 2-on-2, but Bomb's plying down in towards that A site. Kazakhstan, all they've gotta do is trade. They've just gotta wait. Time's ticking, and there's very little time left at that, so Croatia, they're just gonna have to fall back and look to save. They might go aggressive in towards Long, but I mean, I doubt it. They're just gonna wanna take that AWP off of Mo's dead body. And Nyx and Furious both looking to hold onto those guns. Take them into the next round as the scoreline's gonna go 5-5, and we're all tied up. As we go into the 11th round.
It's a pretty wild matchup that we've got unraveling in front of our eyes right now. And like you said, into the 11th round, it's a trade of rounds again. The CTs are going to be the worst for the wear on this one, though. They're not going to be able to formulate a buy. So they're going to have to go into this one with the AK and AWP doing all the work for him, if at all possible. And Nyx, well, where's he going to go? He's going all the way over towards the B-bomb site. He's getting by. They haven't seen Mo actually hit the AWP pick down through middle. Adren, though, aggressive in B. He's going to get picked off. Nick's nice shot, and that's where they now know the AWP is. So now they know they don't need to pressure in towards that bomb site for the time being, at least for the Croatian or for the Kazakhstani side. Let's see what kind of revamp they have. They're going to go around towards Long A, and this is where Revy is with just a P250, so it's unlikely that he's going to really be able to do too much out of this. And you can actually see they threw away the AWP outside of the B bomb site, so switching the position of that one, making it difficult for the CTs to be able to recover it. And now Revy giving up his position, trying to tap away with that P250, try to do the damage, but the Molotov is out. He's going to have to fall back behind this, the nade, and he burns.
Oh, but in mid is going to get one before getting traded down by Stoll. It's going to go 3-on-3 in Croatia. They actually managed to secure a second AWP and an AK out of this. So potential for them to hold on to this round. Nyx is going to be watching that close angle. Does get taken down by Zlex. Mariachi isn't able to land that shot there, and well, as a result, they do manage to get across with the bomb. Bomb goes down towards A, and it's all going to fall onto Mariucci, who I've actually been told is called Mario. And Stoll comes in with one on his legs. Now it's going to go 2-on-2 with Mo and Fitch left to hold onto this site. And well, with Mariucci's positioning, they could potentially hold onto this as he starts to make his way through Long. If he's unheard and Mo doesn't check it, it should be an easy frag for him there. Stoll pushing out of Short isn't able to find one on a pitch, and then Mo down towards Long takes down Mariucci in spectacular form. It's going to go 5-6, and Kazakhstan, they start to pull ahead. One round advantage currently, and we're going to be going into the 12th round now, and they're going to get a very good buy together, whereas Croatia, once again, are going to be forced onto an eco.
Their money is pretty wrecked right now on the CT side. That trade of rounds really, really hurt them. Mo still not able to hit these shots through mid-double doors. He hasn't tagged one yet. Very aggressive play out through Long's. Lex and Adren going to be able to combine to find both of those players. Fitch and mid's going to find Mariucci. And that's just going to leave Revy at Long, who does manage to dink Hobbit, but I think he dinked Hobbit through his... No, he couldn't have been through his teammate. Must have been through the corner of the wall. They definitely heard a dink go out, but it's going to be Nyx trying to get aggressive here from B, and look at this in top mid. Moses ready. And there you go. Takes him down. No joy for Nyx. They had all the angles covered. And that is going to be a 7th round now for Kazakhstan. So they're starting to get a little bit of a lead. They're starting to creep into this one. They've won 7 out of the last 8 rounds. That is a brilliant recovery for Kazakhstan thus far through this thus two match.
Yeah, now we are actually going to be seeing the double up setup coming out for Croatia, and we've seen this work really well on the CT side in the past on Dust. So it is very curious to see what this is going to do for the Croatian side now, as Mariucci and Revy both opting to go for the AWP into the 13th round. Three players over towards this B site, which less than ideal, as Revy does get taken down to 22 HP in mid. That's going to force him out of mid, so they don't have any info as to where the Kazakhstan side are going. For all they know, they could be in lower tunnels, could be on shore. You know, could be 3 kilometers away in a different map. Who knows? But four players now heading up onto that short angle. You've also got over towards long. That's Fitch. And he's going to be facing off up against Furious when the A-split does come underway. Molotov out onto the site. Stoll is trapped here at the back of the site as well. But the rotate should already be underway. He's going to get peaked. And well, Adrent finds it straight away. No one there to trade from as well. And Fitch down towards long takes down Furious. So a complete collapse of the A-site here. And well, at 22 HP, Nyx and Revy. And Mariucci being the only guy at 100 is not the situation they want to be in, and they are just going to be saving at the end of this round.
You talk about a collapse in this round. It's been a collapse on the CT side wholeheartedly from Croatia. They opened up with 4 rounds in a row after getting that pistol round, and things looked really, really good for them. But just like on Overpass, it crumbles quickly. You know, they started off with, what, a 5-0 scoreline? That nade is just insult to injury right there. Zlex is going to be able to find that one. It's Mariucci in the back lines, but Moe's going to get the spam. They're going to lose all their guns. So, again, another round on the board for Kazakhstan as they push forward to an 8-5 scoreline, and only 2 rounds remain in this half, and it's been a recovery. 8 out of the last 9 rounds going the way of the Kazakhstan squad. And they're into this double-up setup now, and Moe's starting to find his form. Adrin's still up there at the top. It's Zlex that's kind of found a little bit. And again, they missed the cross. It's a little unfortunate that they're not able to get that, but Croatia is in this buy-lose save situation. They're trying to get what they can into this final round, but it's going to be very difficult. Fitch there for the trade as Mariucci's trying to go for that rifle in mid. He's not able to get it. That nade could finish off one. Oh, Furious barely able to get away. Only 4 HP left on his chest.
Ooh, but a nice dig out from Revy on a Fitch. It's going to remove that player down from shore, so that's going to alleviate a little bit of pressure over towards the A site. Moe trying to come in and get the trade here, going very aggressive with the AWP, deep in with his teammates. Just going in deep and dry, no flashes or anything. Then my flash does come out over towards long. Two players getting hit by that, but Revy in the corner does get one onto Moe. Still gets one as well, so in the blink of an eye, all falls onto Adren, and it's all falling to pieces here for the Kazakhstan side. All Croatia have to do is not peek, got bombed down, and they just have to trade into the Kazakhstan player. Now the only issue is that you've got just this huge flank coming in from Furious, and that's going to leave it now in a situation where Croatia, they don't have anyone there to trade. So Stoll, he has to land this headshot with the deagle.
Adrin knows he's falling back just in time. Unfortunate. I thought he knew. Furious with only 4 HP, if he gets that pick, he gets himself another 1v1. But a nice job there from Revy. You're going to be able to steal a round away, and Croatia should not have been able to win that round. Given the utility and the firepower that they have, it's a miracle that they get out of that with the win, but it's a beautiful job for them. It's a beautiful recovery all across the board, and it's just not checking angles on the Kazakhstani side. That's really what ended up costing them into that round.
Yeah, because, I mean, it just led Revy to come in and take his head clean off. And, well, Moe heading down through mid with the AWP in hand. He does also have the bomb gun for an aggressive play here. Nyx and Mariucci also pushed in towards those B tunnels to get the information early on, amigos. And, well, down in mid, you got three players for the Kazakhstan side here. Boost coming out, though, from Stoll with that AWP. Should allow them to find an opening frag here if they do decide to go for a mid to B play, but it doesn't look like they're going to just yet. And, well, Hobbit's going to be there trying to pick the angle, isn't going to find anyone as they do fall back the players on towards that B site. Over towards long, you've got Revy and also Furious trying to watch the long angle. Revy, of course, opting for that short from CarPlay that we've seen him use so many times in the past. And, well, like per usual, if he does manage to start this off by getting a frag, he's going to completely delay this A push. But, I mean, still, a nice smoke does mean that Fitch gets past completely unchecked and finds that kill on a stall. Mariachi comes in with the trade. And, well, Hobbit does get the return frag there, put into a 4-on-3. But the one-man advantage leaning towards the Kazakhstan side. Nyx taking Hobbit's head clean off as it's going to go into a 3-on-3. Molotov out in towards the window. And, well, bomb going down now over towards that B site.
This is going to be a very difficult retake here for the CTs. They're almost out of utility. They've got one flash to work with. Moe's holding this angle. He's going to get a wall bang. Drops another player very low. That's the upper in Revy. Zlex Well, Furious should be a dead man. Spots the gun barrel. He's going to get the timing right. Takes him down. Now trying to come through the window. And Drin, again, going to be able to find one. Going to be looking for the final frag here. And it is going to be Revy just trying to fall back. But 9-6 halftime score for Kazakhstan as they reclaim that three-round lead going into the second half. And this is going to be a pretty crucial pistol round. If Croatia can't pick this up, that's going to give an opportunity for Kazakhstan to get up to 12, barring a bomb plant in the opening round for Croatia. And it's just going to be kind of a struggle for him moving forward. This is Kazakhstan's map pick. Keep that in mind. Kazakhstan was able to take Croatia on overpass with a tremendous win. I believe it was 16-8, 16-9. So that's a pretty hardy win for Kazakhstan on a map that they didn't pick.
Yeah, no, I couldn't agree more. So we got into the first round of the second half. Kazakhstan, they are fully aware this A play is going to be underway. Hobbit spraying through, isn't able to find anyone just yet. Furious is going to be the first guy to pick the site. He also has the bomb in tow. And while he's able to pick up one onto Hobbit, now it's going to go into a 4-on-5. Rotate's already underway. Mo gets one with that USP. Revy finds the return on his legs. It's going to go into a 3-on-4 as bomb goes down over towards that A site. And, well, just looking at it, you've got Mariucci all the way down towards long there. He's going to be able to pick up the kill on a Dren. Now it's going to go 2-on-4. And at this point, all Croatia have to do is out-trade the Kazakhstan players as Nyx finds one on a Mo. It's all going to fall in a fish. He's boxed himself into a corner. Does get one for his troubles. But Nyx completes the double kill there. And it's going to go 7-9 as Croatia, they do pick up the first pistol round.
Nyx was the hero of the opening pistol round for the Croatian side, too. Remember, he got that 4K with the USP lightning fast there in mid. Picks up one, goes all the way up towards the A bomb site, picks off one crossing, and then gets the double peek on long A and finds an extra kill. And that's really an awesome start for them to go forward. I like this positioning from Fitch. He gets right out in mid, but he's going to, well, they're just going to rush into B, and this is going to be really difficult for the Kazakhstan side to hold on to. Adren's going to go down. There's one more player by window, and that is going to be, well, it was Mo, but he's dead. Sad times.
Yeah, Fitch with that scout trying to do all he can, isn't able to do anything, does get taken down, and Zlek's armor and a CZ is all that remains for the Kazakhstan side. Nyx is going to spot him out, and now he's got Mariucci and Nyx both peeking him, and of course they are going to come off the better in that duel, and while it's going to go 8-9 with Croatia, they should be able to equalize things out at a 9-all scoreline into the 19th round.
And again, I mean, just the recovery here from Croatia, they're keeping it competitive, they're keeping it close into this one. Furious is going to be on the scout, but they've got the SMGs for the remaining players on the Croatian side. And it's a stock vanilla round. They didn't even buy anything into this round. $1,000, as you can see at the top of the screen there, underneath the Kazakhstan flag, shows you the investment into the round. And those stock pistols are $200 a piece, so they're going to be right on those stock tools. They haven't upgraded anything, haven't bought down anything into this round. And they're going to go aggressive on Cat. This should be heard from Long. Yeah, you can actually see Mariucci setting himself up for this.
A potential for the 4K of his entry with this MAC-10. He gets one, he goes in for the second, he makes it two, he makes it three, he goes for the fourth. Can he get it? Fitch is going to be able to come in and just deny that 4K spray down completely. But still a really nice hat-trick there coming in from Mariucci. And well, it's all going to fall on a Fitch now. Revy comes in from long with the UMP, and he gets taken down as well. 9-9 is going to be the scoreline, and look at Mariucci's bank account. My God, I want him to be my sugar daddy. Okay, and now it's going to go the 19th
round.
That's fair enough. Looking at this, there are going to be players peeking mid. It's going to be Revy with that AWP, trying to watch the cross. Isn't able to find anything just yet. Zlex gets one on the Nyx, so to start things off a good way for the Kazakhstan side. Stoll comes in, gets a return on a Mo. Hobbit, though, in with a return of his own, puts it back into a one-man advantage for the Kazakhstan side. And while now Furious, Revy, and Mariucci are all that remain for the Croatians here. Smoke down into mid as it does look like they're trying to change things up, change up this strategy, and Adren's going to flash through. Is he going to be able to find anyone as he does peek mid? He gets a little bit of information. He sees one of the players hopping across, and well, he should be able to call to his team that there is a mid-presence coming out from the Croatian side right about now. And, well, Kazakhstan, they're just holding passive. That's all they have to do. Two players on each site. And that should be more than enough to hold off the impending attack from the Croatians.
Should be. We'll see. AWP in the hands for Revy. Going to be the first point of contention up here on Catwalk. They're going to flash, and they're going to send, okay, they're not going to send the Alper down into CT spawn. That's the right call. There's no smoke down there either, so if he drops down, he could have been potentially a dead man. But this passive setup from the CT side, they're just going to play it for a retake. They have yet to get that bomb plant up on the top side of A bomb site, but They are eventually going to get that. Now remember, Zlex is down 15 HP, so the retake from Long A is going to be excruciatingly difficult for the Kazakhstan side. The other player that's down there is going to have to hit the shots. I believe that's Hobbit. Let's stand there, and here comes the pinch onto this A bomb site. They are pushing their way on up. The off shot's going to rain out. Revy's not going to be able to connect, and just like that, it's going to be all the players down. As Hobbit finishes off Furious, it will be another round on the board here for the Kazakhstan side. As they clean that one out. 10-9 now the scoreline. They finally get something going. It's the first gun round of the CT half. They're going to be able to pick that one up. And an up for Mo. Why not?
Yeah, no, the Mo and AWP, the AWP on Mo, it's been one of those days. The AWP on Mo has been so instrumental to Kazakhstan's success, and once seeing him pick that up again should bode well for them. But saying that, Revy down mid, showing that he's the better AWPer, as Mo does get taken down in the early stage of this game. That's going to weaken that B hold so much, as Adren had to rotate in to try and watch mid, and he gets taken down as well. So now it's a two-man advantage for Croatia, all off the back of that one opening frag from Revy. It's all going to fall now onto... onto Fitch to try and hold off the B site. He's going to get taken down, and in the blink of an eye, Zlex and Hobbit, they're the last remaining hope for the Kazakhstan side, and they're just going to be looking to save. Mariachi over towards Long is going to be there trying to find a kill on one of these Kazakhstan players at least. They should be able to out-trade him here, but I mean, even if he takes down one, that's such a dent to their economy. Zlex gets caught looking the wrong way. Mariachi finds one, and well, with the potential to find the second coming from Long as well, it's stolen. That's going to be them going down. As Zlex does get one kill for his trouble, but they lose two rifles in the process. Now the score is going to go 10-10 as we head into the 21st round. And it's going to be an eco for Kazakhstan. So potential for this to go to map number 3.
Yeah, and we'll have to see. I mean, this is the save round here for Kazakhstan. This is a golden opportunity for Croatia to get a little bit of momentum, get a little bit of something going for themselves into this half. And I don't like that play at all, but it does get rectified. Revy goes a little bit too aggressive with the AWP, loses his life to the CZ-75 there at Long A from Zlex, but it does get immediately rectified with Nick's 2 kills. So all is forgiven. Furious though, around Long A, he's going to be able to spot out the player there. That's Mo going down. Maybe a little interp on that last bullet, but it's going to be okay. Another close play here from CT Slope, and Skull and Mariucci going to be able to finish that round off. So Croatia pick up their 11th. They get into the lead for the first time since the 8th round. And it is 5 out of the 6 rounds so far on the T side for them have gone their way. So we'll see if they can continue that trend moving forward, as we will see another buyout here. Hobbit on a UMP, so it's not the most formidable of buys. Though trying to line up that shot at the beginning of the round, not going to be able to connect, but he does see Stoll, I believe, pushing aggressively here towards Green Box's top mid. Oh, he definitely spotted him now. But he should be able to just hold this angle. Somehow Hobbit recovered. I don't know how that was a thing.
Yeah, no, me neither. Revy and Mo doing their usual dance in mid. No damage being exchanged between the two players just yet. And like you say, Hobbit picking up that frag over towards Long. The miracle frag is going to allow Kazakhstan to sport a one-man advantage here. And as a result, Croatia, they're having to adjust to this on the fly. I mean, you've still got that bomb down in T-spawn. Very little sense of direction from them right now. I think they're hoping to capitalize on some sort of pick. But I mean, right now, nothing like that is materializing. And, well, we have Sal seen Mo. He's pushed down in the mid trying to watch that angle, but he's not going to find anyone. Kazakhstan playing this perfectly. They're just playing this so passively. They're not giving Croatia a mistake or, you know, them overextending or anything to capitalize on, and are leaving them in a situation where they've effectively hung them out to dry. I mean, they have to make a play. 50 seconds left. Bomb still down in T-spawn. Furious finally rotating through to go get it. And it is looking like A is going to be the site in question that the Croatian side are going to decide to hit. But I mean, Mo's watching this angle over on short with the AWP. He's in a very good place right now.
No, not at all. Fitch is going to come under attack here. They are going to go executing out from mid with a late lurk down from Catwalk, but that's going to be Mo that's going to be able to lock that down if it ever comes to fruition. But Revy able to trade back. Adrian goes down. Very low player in mid, but they've split they've split this offense. And now Furious is stuck in tunnels. They've got no time. They've got to be able to find that pick in the B bomb site, and it just isn't happening fast enough, and Kazakhstan are going to be able to answer back. There is a decent amount of money here on the Croatian side. Because they got 5 out of the opening 6 rounds, they're going to have plenty of money to buy down, drop weapons, and be able to re-equip going into this. But Kazakhstan going directly into this double up setup, and Adren and Mo, they didn't really do too much with this in that opening T half. So I'm curious why they continue to go back to this.
Yeah, I mean, old habits die hard, and that's what Mo and Adren are showing us right now. Now Dust's fine. One, I mean, Furious and Mariucci coming out long. They take down Hobbit and Mo. And now it's going to go into a 3-on-5. Adren coming in with the AWP, trying to show that he's, you know, worth more than we've given him credit for with it currently, as he is going to be peeking long. Mariucci's going to be there. Not able to pick up a kill just yet. That bomb's going to be heading back, though, off of the long angle. I think they're just trying to, you know, they don't want to rush into it just yet, seeing as you've got two Kazakhstan players over there. And over towards B, you've got Nyx. He does peek things out, but Fitch finds him. Now it's going to go 3-on-3 thanks to that frag. And well, 5 HP on Furious does mean that the advantage now is actually leaning towards Kazakhstan, despite a really, really good, you know, start to the round coming out from Croatia.
Yeah, the only benefit behind that for Furious is that he does have the AWP. So as long as there's no nades, which there are two left on the CT side for right now, plus a smoke and a flash. So if they do nade when they go across, then he'll surely be a dead man. They're just going to walk up here. They haven't thrown the smoke out. There's the flash. They're just going to walk across, try to waltz their way out here, and it's going to get completely shut down. And there you go. Adrenaline's Lex, they had the utility to cross for that. They could have, you know, maybe dropped Molotovs or something to get the smoke plume up from that and try to find the picks out that way or try to get across that way, but they just decided to dry peek it and not use anything. It's a little bit misfortunate.
No, that was really weird, like a tactical blunder, I think. They just minced across and you know, saw what they could do. They couldn't do anything.
They actually had two smokes.
Yeah, they had everything they needed. They had
two smokes and two Molotovs. Adrenaline aggressive up top, mid's gonna be able to find one. He's gonna eventually get traded out, but that nade does a good amount of damage to those lower B players. So finding that early little bit of information, Fitch through the smoke, gonna find Nyx just before it blooms. Look at Hobbit, top mid. I think they heard this. Yeah, Mariucci hears it. Nice shot from him. Oh, Fitch! What? Just decided to spam the smoke and he finds Furious from the backside. Furious isn't having any fun into this matchup right now. He's 7-13. It's just not having a lot of luck, but Fitch over at B. They've cleared out A. Bomb is going to get picked up and rotated, but Fitch coming around towards CT spawn. He's going to cut off this rotation potentially. The bomb works its way in towards the B bomb site. He knows that they picked up the bomb. He has to know. He's going to come out around on Mariucci here. And unfortunately not going to be able to hit that shot at the full house. 3 kills for Mariucci, 2 for Stoll. And a pretty nice round there from Croatia as they tie things back up. And that's going to be another money reset here for Kazakhstan.
Yep, and you know, this match is a hell of a lot closer than the previous map, despite it being Kazakhstan's map pick. And I think a large detriment to that is actually the fact that when you look at Mariucci, second on the scoreboard, whereas in the previous map, we were saying how much of a key player he's been in the past, and you know, he was failing to provide. But anyway, going into the 25th round, everyone's long. Stoll's going to start things off in a good way with that frag on a Hobbit. That's going to open up that long angle and leave these two players out to dry over towards the site. Of course, now boost going up to the site as Mo does get boosted, but I mean, it might be too little too late. Nate goes in as well. They're already very, very close here, and they basically rotated the entire Kazakhstan force in. Mo does get one. Furious gets one of his own there to try and equalize things out. But Mo and Adren doing work over towards that site. Managed to take down three players respectively. And it's all going to fall on Arebi. He gets taken down by Zlex with a P250. And that does mean it's going to go 12-13 with Kazakhstan trying to pull ahead, trying to get back into this and approach map point.
Yeah, and again, I mean, it's another unlikely round that gets won by Kazakhstan. They go for a force buy with 3 pistols, an M4, and an AWP, and somehow make it work. And that's really going to be a detriment to the economy. I mean, look at Revy. He's on a Glock with head armor. Why the hell is he on a Glock? Why would you even buy head armor in that situation? Maybe he auto-bought and dropped an AK for a teammate? They do throw it over to him. But now Nyx is on a Glock with head armor. I don't know what's really going on here. The only upgraded pistol is going to be on Furious, who's dead. So now at least Nyx might be able to go and find a pistol, and he does, so he gets the Deagle. But a little bit strange there. A little strange.
Yeah, no, Furious going down. Not good for Croatia, like you say. And, well, I mean, they've managed to pick up his Deagle, I believe, on Stoll. Adren's going to be able to pick up one. Revy does get a nice return, but Adren coming in with two now. That's going to put it into a 2-on-4, and as a result, Bomb's going to be heading up through lower tunnels, out towards the B site. Mariucci has managed to make his way out. Gets Mo down to 40 HP for his troubles. Adren's on 20 as well. And, well, Hobbit gets dropped in the process. Now, Mariucci. Oh, my God, kill me. Mariucci, 4 HP. And, yeah, no, come on down to the Mexican buffet tonight. Nyx, out. out that window, gets two though, so suddenly this whole round flipped on his head as it all falls onto Adren. Mariachi manages to find him, and there we go, it's gonna go 13 all. As Nyx, with the unexpected window play, managing to drop those two Kazakhstan players, and they've got to be feeling bad after that. They have to be.
Well, it's mainly just been this turnaround here from Nyx. I mean, he's had a hell of a second map here. Mariucci's now up with him at 23 and 16, so they're both pulling their weight wholeheartedly. It's really Mo and Adren not being able to take over this map right now, and that's really costing them. You know, you got these all-star players, these legends, status players on your team. You need them to be stepping up, and this is good positioning from Adren, but he's only able to find one out of that. Furious is going to trade him out, and Revy gets the final kill, so a 14th round now for Croatia. It's the last chance to dance here for the CT side. They're going to have to force into this round.
Yep, they go for that double orb setup that we've seen be devastatingly not that effective. And they're going to try and do what they can with it. 14-13 is going to be the scoreline. One round away from map point for the Croatian side. Modo starting things off in a great way, finding that frag on Arebi. Remaining players heading over towards the B site. Bomb going down. Furious does manage to secure the plant. 3-on-4
should be
currently.
I know that people get triggered when I say that they should save, but it's 14-13. It's a 4-on-3. They should probably fall back and save this one. The HP values aren't very low on the Terra side players. They do find Mariucci. So there is a chance into this round now, but I mean, all three of them coming from the same spot. You've got a player at car, you got a player backside, you got a player on flat. Molotov goes out through double doors, and now you've lost two players. So I don't think I would have really gone for that. I would have saved and, you know, played for the overtime, but that's just me.
Yep, I do agree. Kazakhstan now, 15-13, and while they are forced onto an ECAD. Now, do you want to know the funny thing? The analysts, if you remember, they swapped their opinion.
They did. They failed on Croatia.
Yeah, they said, nah, okay, fine. Croatia, they ain't got it. Mega Man and Harry, you guys are right. We're horrible people. Kazakhstan, they're going to take this easy. Well, this is why you got to listen to your mind and your heart, fellas. It's important to listen to both. Apparently, just alternate between the two. And, 15-13 is going to be the scoreline. 3-on-5. Bomb's going to be going down over on that B site. It's all going to fall on Zlex, Hobbit, and Fitch to try and retake this. Revy's coming in from behind as well. So even if Fitch doesn't get taken down here by Mariachi, but he does regardless, Hobbit's going to be the last guy left alive. He's got a scout and a CZ. Does pick up one, but he's going to get taken down by Furious. 16-13 is going to be the scoreline. And well, that means we're only going to map number 3. The decider, of course, will be Cash. And, what can I say? I mean, the analysts, they were let down by their hearts and their minds today. And I think they need to go home and have a nice long think about this. Maybe sit down, have a little glass of wine, and just refamiliarize yourself with why you got into this in the first place, boys.
Either that or say and go straight for like the heavy booze, you know?
Yeah.
drink your problems away, boys, because your predictions are a little bit off right now. George, can you set them straight for us, man?